discounts, there's like policy, I don't get totally angry, no more discounts on summonses. Is it good for only summonses or JBJ summonses?
As far as we are concerned, we will only decide on JBJ because it's under NOT. Of course, PDRL will be under Ministry of Home Affairs, Kementerian Dalam Negeri. But of course, I think moving forward, we hope that it has to be a same policy, a consistent policy. That the reason why we do not want to give discount is that we do not want to give a wrong signal, a wrong message to the public. That summons is that you can wait for discounts, so that people don't really bother about being penalized if they commit any offence. So the important point that I want to make is that the policy that we put in place is that once you commit an offence, then you have to be penalized. Then only they feel it. If they don't feel it, they don't feel the penalty, then people don't care. People don't change their habit. The driver don't change their attitude. We want to create a climate of fear to the drivers not to commit offence on the roads. That is the point that we want to make. It's not that we want to make it hard for people. So people say that, oh, ini tak bagi discount, kita nak tukar. Janganlah, kalau tak nak bayar saman, janganlah langgar peraturan jalan raya. You jangan, takut apa dengan speed camera tu kalau kamu tak speed. The reason why we want to put the cameras is not so much we want to collect summons. We want to make sure that people slow down. I mean, this is a psychological effect. Everyone who travel North South Highway, tengok ada kalau ada kamera, mesti dia slow down. Kebanyakan lah, not everyone. Kebanyakan, I think 90% of the drivers will slow down. Because they know there is a camera there. And why we put certain cameras in that location is that it's an accident prone area. So that by putting that camera in an accident prone area, we hope that it will reduce accident. The thing that we are different from the previous government is that it's not so much about putting the speed camera. It is about the nature of the enforcement. What we opposed previously on the AES is not AES per se. It is the privatization of AES, the privatization of enforcement. That what we oppose. Because every summon issued under the previous AES regime, a certain amount was given to the private company. Half of the summon are being paid to the private company. So the company, the motivation of the company is to issue more summons because it's a profit oriented. For us, it's different. For us, what we want to achieve is that to reduce the number of summons being issued. Because if there are reduction of summons being issued, it means that people are obeying the speed limit. That's our motivation. That's the difference between us and the previous regime.
Just now you mentioned that you hope can have same policy. That means you hope that police can stop giving discount on summons as well.
Well, that's of course our the decision lies in the hand of Ministry of Home Affairs. But that is something that I will convey the message to the Home Minister as well.
You will discuss with
PDT.
Yes, I will convey that message. And same goes to PDT. PBT local councils. Local councils, I also see local councils are giving some discounts and so on. Of course, why we want to start off afresh is that don't forget those people who say that we don't take into consideration kita pindah tiba rasa dan sebagainya. Jangan lupa bahawa kita batalkan hampir 4.3 juta saman AES. Berjumlah 600 million, apa 600 juta kita hapuskan, one off kita clear kan, yang semua kena sama AES dulu tu yang tak payah tu kita hapuskan, clear dia punya rekod semua clear dalam JBJ. Tapi bermula 1 September kita nak cakap that is only one off, but after 1 September siapa kena saman kalau tak payah then we will blacklist.
Does your ministry have any studies or statistics to show that the implementation of the AES is actually beneficial towards reducing the accident rate?
You need long term statistics and so on. But as I said, generally people, once you see a camera, they will reduce the speed in that particular area. we know, I mean, drivers' behavior. The moment after the camera, they will speed. I mean, be honest lah, we all know that. Saya juga pemandu. So, pemandu punya behavior macam tu lah. Kalau tengok kamera, dia akan slow down. Everyone will slow down in Kacang. Because they know there's an AES camera there. Everyone will slow down the moment they see a camera. Tapi kita nak, apa yang kita buat, memang it will not be 100%. We know that. I mean, no, nothing is perfect. Nothing can be 100%. Takkan kita nak letak kamera setiap 500 meter. That's impossible. We are not going to put like 1,000 cameras around the Gaza Highway. That was the plan of the previous AES company. Under the agreement, 1,000 cameras. They want to cash you everywhere. But our motivation is not about summons. Our motivation is not about collecting revenue. Our motivation is about reducing road fatalities.